What's up, guys, and welcome back to Minecraft PlayStation 4 Edition, and today we got a lot of things to do. I had sort of an idea of what I wanted to figure out, because, of course, one of the biggest obstacles I have right now is trying to find a nether star, and I've been running into issues. A lot of you guys have been giving me some awesome suggestions, but I figured going through this nether portal and trying to run around, it seems like we're having a hard time finding new stuff or getting out farther and farther just because there's so much, you know, scary bad guys and everything. So I figured, why don't we relocate and try to find a new make a new nether portal and maybe find some new stuff there. Maybe we'll get a little bit more luck, because if we walk through here and everything we explore is off that way. So I was figuring, why don't we go to our little sand village that we've had over way over there for the longest time, and we set up another nether portal. So I figure on our way there, we'll go ahead and get more nether stuff. We'll do a bunch of different stuff that I plan on doing, but first we need this. All right then, so I was thinking we'd do like the whole kit and caboodle, or however you want to explain that. Basically, I want to go ahead and maybe set up sort of like an extra base at the desert area. I feel like that would be a really cool thing, just so that we have more room to do things, so that we have more place to store things. You know, if I'm way over the desert area and I'm trying to kill Endermen, I don't have to run all the way back home, that kind of stuff. So with that being said, I think we need more food. Why don't we get half of that? And honestly, this half a sack should feed us for a long time. I'm gonna go ahead and put that here, and we're gonna go ahead and cook that up. While that is cooking up, like I said, I have some other things to do, like knock down trees. Now, I've been wanting to record the series for the last little while. That cow is freaking out. You okay, Mr. Cow? Do you need to be like knocked off of there? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize that would have one-shot you. I probably should have thought about that. Sorry, buddy. Well, yeah, we're gonna go ahead and knock down some trees. It looks like it's starting to get a little dark, but it's okay, it's okay. I mean, oh man, you guys know who've been watching the series. You guys know that recently the series has been obviously a fun time just sitting back playing some Minecraft, but it's also been sort of my place to sort of talk about real life stuff that's been going on with me. And there has sort of been a lot, especially with the cats. I mean, I talk about the cats a lot in this series. I hope nobody minds. Like, nobody has said they mind. Like, hey, shut up, stop talking about zebra life and play Minecraft. And nobody seems to have an issue. I think that's why it's like, it's a good fit, because it's like Minecraft is like a really fun game to play while thinking and talking about other stuff. You know, it's like you sort of zone out, knocking down trees and burning up, or not burning, cooking up fish. But you good, I mean. So I figure it's like, man, where to start? This last month has been a little crazy for me. So the last time I talked to you guys about it, okay. So we caught a new cat the last time we talked to you. So we had caught a new stray cat the last time we talked to you guys, or at least I was talking about how I went out to go feed some local animals. You know, like I explained that all in the last episode. Definitely check it out if you haven't already, so that you're not utterly confused. But simply put, like, we went out and then we put out a cat cage, which is, you know, super safe. You know, we got it from animal control, who, you know, are people who design the cages so that they're safe. And we've actually caught a cat in it before and everything's worked out fine. We put the cage out and it was actually surprisingly easy to catch her. Usually cats, especially if they're stray, will avoid any kind of contact with anything, because obviously they've either been abandoned or hurt or never were in contact with people or zebras in the first place, so they'll be afraid of them, you know? So for a stray cat to be approaching us was actually really peculiar, and being very willing to, you know, hop into the cage and then being brought inside. And we sort of figured out why. She is a stray cat, which means she's never had interaction with humans before. I gotta stop zoning out really quick. Hold on, what do we need to do right now? Well, first we need to sleep, then go and get more wood. But if you don't know, a stray cat, okay, let's say a feral cat. A feral cat, that word means basically, if you don't know, it means a cat who was born and has never had interaction with humans. So basically they were born either outside, or maybe they were kicked out of the home right as a young kitten. So they didn't know what a human is, or that a human's not there to hurt them. It's, you know, most humans are out there to help kittens, you know, that kind of idea. So we had a lot of signs that this cat was a feral cat because she was, you know, not neutered, and she was just simply, you could tell she didn't understand what, you know, what was going on inside of a home, you know? So we have like a little safe room for her, and we noticed that her, like, how she acted was really peculiar. She would spend all night meowing at the window like she wanted to go outside, but of course she wasn't trying to leap out of it or anything. She wasn't trying to leave. And there was a lot of little peculiar things like that. She had a really big appetite. And after doing some research and talking to a vet, it turns out she's actually might be having babies. Now, when it comes to cats having babies, it's really weird because they're pregnant for about 2 months and you don't really see the signs of them getting a big belly until like the last few weeks. So if we're going to be, you know, having a few kittens roaming around the house, we'll find out probably by the end of July, these next few weeks. If not, maybe it's just a weird coincidence, because obviously the fact that, and we named her Jazzy, by the way, Jasmine, and her nickname is Jazzy. I got to name her this time, which made me feel cool. But Jazzy, like I said, she was very upfront about, you know, joining us in our home, which is very atypical for a feral cat. So chances are she might be having some little kittens, and that's exciting, but it's also scary, of course. That just means, you know, more cats to take care of, which is great, but at the same, you know, it's just more mouths to feed, more hard work to do, which is okay. It's absolutely okay. It's just also a little crazy. Not only that, but some other thing has been going on. Oh gosh, the list continues when I say it like that. But, okay, the fish should be done cooking. I'm trying to talk about the story, because honestly, while I am enjoying playing Minecraft, I've really been wanting to get all this stuff off my mind, because honestly, I've been so busy, I haven't had really anybody to talk to about it. So while, you know, I'm not like upset and like, oh, everything's so hard right now, nothing's like that. But I, of course, I want to be able to talk about this stuff because it's going on in my life. But while all this is happening, we met somebody at a local pet store, just one getting litter. And they were talking about they have a cat and they might need a new home. So we like exchanged information, they gave us their phone number. A week later they call and they say they've been evicted from their house, which if you don't know what that means, it means like, if you're not, like, everybody has rough times nowadays. It's just, that's how life is. So apparently they got evicted from their house because they weren't able to pay for it. Either if you live in an apartment or a house, if you can't pay for it, the bank will take it, or person who owns an apartment will take it, and they'll hire people to get your stuff out. So someday you're just gonna come home from work and people are taking all of your belongings out of your house. You know, that's what evicting means. And it's a really sad thing. Luckily, I haven't had to go through it, but I know people who have, and it's always emotional and sad. So they came to us and they go, we just got evicted from our house and we have nowhere to go. Of course, we're not gonna expect to stay at your house because we don't know you, but we know you take care of cats and we have nowhere to go with this cat because they don't like cats in the hotels, of course. I mean, I don't think it should be an of course thing, and I don't think there's any kitty hotels. I know there are doggy hotels, but I mean, none that would really cause, you know, cost a fortune. You know, because, you know, I know dog hotels cost a lot, and of course you can't afford to do that kind of stuff if, you know, you just got evicted from your house, you can't even pay to live in your own home. How can you pay for something like that? So of course we said yes, we're taking care of the cat. His name is Eli, but we usually call him Biggie, just because that's what they said his nickname was, and he responds to it better. He is so cute, he's adorable, he's so fluffy, and he's just, it's so cute and also so sad because you can tell he's stressed out because he wants his mommy, kind of thing. And it's just like, all cats are just little toddler babies, you know? It's funny because cats are so similar to toddlers. But so not only have we had one new addition to the house, we've had another one, which means another mouth to feed, another thing to figure out, and more chores to do, more, you know, litter to take care of. There's just been a lot stacking on top of me and, you know, everybody else in the household. It's not like a negative thing, like, oh, what are we gonna do about all these stinking cats? We're glad to be here taking care of them. But with everything, you know, it's an extra stress. If we wanna take care of people in need, they're in need. So you have to supply that need. And it just takes a lot of effort. And that's why I am super appreciative of you guys, because if you might notice this last month or so, instead of having two or three videos up a day, it's been one, maybe, you know, maybe just one video, sometimes no videos up every day. And I know that's a big change, and I know that's a negative change, so I thank you guys so much for your patience with all that kind of stuff. I really, really appreciate it. But because of this, I've also been running into my own issues, I guess. Like, I've ran into an odd amount of fatigue that honestly I'm thinking about like talking to my doctor about. Like, I'm so tired all the time, and like, it might be like, I've been depressed before in my life, so has everybody. I go by the mantra, yeah, life can be hard, but I've never met somebody in my life who has had an easy life. So I always keep that in mind, and it usually makes things easier for me. Look out for other people, and people usually look out for you. But I've had this incredible amount of fatigue recently, and of course, I've been stepping up to the plate. If cats need taken care of, I take care of them. If somebody needs a driver, I'm there to drive them, you know, like, usually I meet my responsibilities, but when it comes time to do what makes me happy and what I do for a living, this YouTube stuff, by the time I can even get to it, I'm already like about to pass out tired, you know? And I think a mixture of that is being busy, and a mixture of it maybe is being a tad bit just, I wouldn't say depressed, but just, you know, tired, exhausted in physically and emotionally? Why won't this break? Come on, break. But because of that, it's just like, I feel like that's just a reason why I've had less videos. I've been really trying very hard to make sure the videos aren't bad or anything, and I really hope they're not. Not only that, but I've been playing, because of that, I've been playing games really badly. And I've noticed some people have noticed and they've sort of gotten upset about it. Like, most of you are really cool about it. You're super duper nice. Even like, you know, you guys watch the videos from me. Not if I'm, you know, a Minecraft expert or anything like that, but... And I appreciate that, I really, really do. And I'm sorry for those of you who watch me to be a Minecraft expert or in any other game, Garden Warfare expert or anything like that. I always try my best when playing games, but... It's, you know, there's only so much I can do sometimes. Where is this lava? There's a lava pit somewhere around here. Maybe we passed it? I know there's one around. We'll be looking around for it. But yeah, today's just sort of a tangent episode, so I'm sorry if that's a little meh for people. If you don't like that, let me know. I'm definitely just all ears with this kind of stuff. But all that's just been stacking on top of me. And, you know, it just... It's weird how the world looks, you know, works like that, because it's like, I'm never going to give up on that idea of taking care of people and things and animals, but even then I see animals as people, but you know what I mean? Oh, here we go. Ah, we hit the gold mine, or the lava mine, or something. We need a few of these. I will never stop taking care of who I think deserves help, which is just about everybody, you know? Everybody who needs a hand, either be through entertainment, through my videos. No! Dang it. I guess I should have brought a water bucket, but I was hoping things wouldn't work out like that. We'll have to see. Let me see if I can't snag this. Okay, there's water in this one. Good, good, good. But either be through entertainment or through me helping directly, there's a lot of good I want to do for this world, you know? So it stacks on, and I know it's just not me. I know that the people that are close to me have been struggling with the same thing, and it can be just so tough. I mean, even today, we pulled into the house at like 10:30 p.m. and we saw a cat we've never seen before sitting on the porch. And it's like, especially in the neighborhood I've lived in for the last year and, you know, the neighborhoods I have lived in, usually most people who are letting their cats out past midnight every night, typically they don't care for the cat. Like, the cat isn't being, like, if a cat is out that late at night, they probably don't have a home to come back to, you know? So the fact that the cat is just sitting there on our porch, you know, probably means it doesn't have a home. And it's funny that it chose our porch, the people who take in cats all the time. It knew. Or I should have called it. It was probably a he or a she, I'm not sure. But we were thinking about calling him Bobby, if he's a boy, if we ever are able to bring him into our home. Because we tried to say hi to him, he ran away. And then, yeah, that happened two or three nights in a row now. We've tried to, you know, say hi to him when we see him at our house and he'll run away. But you can obviously see he's going for the food that we leave out. And if that's happening the same time every night, chances are, once again, he doesn't have a home. So we're gonna set up the cat cage and see if we can maybe get him and bring him into our home and see if everything works out that way. Of course, if he ends up being somebody else's cat, we never like steal a cat or anything. I think some people get worried about that, but it's like, that's not really an issue because it's like, once again, if somebody leaves their cat out every day and night and never lets them in for food or anything, typically that's not actually their home, you know? There's something going on there that's negative, you know? All right then, so we're doing okay though. So I brought most of that wood back to the house. I mean, I wanted a good stock there and I figured maybe we could get more here. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and sort of start building a base way off this way. I know I eventually need to extend this. But I know that's gonna be sort of like a super long and boring escapade that I'm not sure too many people wanna watch anyways, but you get what I mean. So it's just like, I'm trying my best here, everybody. And I appreciate it. I just wanna say thank you to everybody who's given me patience, because honestly, that's all I really want right now, if that makes any sense. Hi, bunny. But that's how I really run right now, is just patience. So thank you guys so much for giving that to me without even having to ask. Most of you are incredibly kind and patient, and just, we have the best community in the world. I'm so proud of the Z-Bird. I need to clean up your guys' living space. Creepers and zombies have ruined, and so have I, sort of, kind of, with all this. I feel so bad. These guys have had a rough time here in this neighborhood. We don't have any sheep around here, but there is some nice open chest for us to take advantage of that we will. So why don't we go ahead and put in what I have found already. We'll keep the bows and arrows because we can also spend some time out here catching Endermen, maybe planning some of this food. It would have been great if we brought a bed, but I'm forgetful old zebra, so I'm gonna forget to do things because that's what a forgetful person does, is forget things. Ooh, come on now. There you go. And pick all of this up. But back on what I was saying about me being tired all the time, never worry. I know some people hear that kind of stuff and they get scared. I'm not quitting YouTube anytime soon. I feel like some people are like, Zebra, I hope you never quit YouTube. It's like, of course I won't. never a thought in my head. I've been doing this for almost 10 years now. It'll be my 7-year anniversary in October. So we're coming up on 10 years. I'm growing some gray hairs nowadays. But I'm never ever gonna just throw in the towel. This is what I love to do. And I'm just so glad that each and every day more people are joining in the Zebra Herd to enjoy it with me, you know? All right, so that's just about all I can get there. There is some wheat here that I could turn into bread if need be. But for right now, I think that I'm gonna eat up. I'm gonna start hunting down some Endermen if I can find any. And anything else. If we could find some sheep, that would be a big deal. So we might go down to the forest. Uh-oh. I hear a spy door. A door that's a spy. Ow! Oh no, run dude, run! Okay, this is bad. All right, I'm gonna bring all the scary monsters away from here, away from the premises here. And hopefully I can be like super good at like battling, because of course I've been playing Minecraft Battle Mode. Minecraft Battle Mode has came out since we have last joined you guys here on the Minecraft PS4 series. It has been a blast, so much fun playing that. It's a lot of fun. If you haven't seen it already, I think it's one of the most fun things I've done this year. So definitely go check it out if you haven't already. There's like 6 or 7 episodes up. It's so much fun. I really hope they add more mini games soon. People have been asking me like, what mini games would I like to see added? I've answered the question on like live streams and stuff. I would really like to see a hide and seek. Like some of you guys suggested like, oh, a hide and seek mini game would be cool. I want something that's like now non-PvP. You know, like we've had our, you know, slice of PvP fun. It would be really cool if we have something now non-PvP. Just sort of mix things up a little bit. Did I pick up? I didn't, there's not one that looks like it's being dropped. But because of that, you might notice that, you know, my turning speed's a little higher. I've sort of gotten used to it like this, so I'm gonna keep it this way if nobody minds. I'm always worried that changing that kind of stuff is gonna like disorient people and make them feel sick, because I know first person games like this can sometimes make people feel like a little motion sick. But yeah, if I've been sounding different, if I've been playing games differently, it really is that I'm tired. And I know a big response is like, oh Zebra, then why don't you go on a vacation? I'll give you guys like a personal tidbit about me. I hate vacations. I hate the idea of going out somewhere because it's just the whole time I'm sitting there wishing I was home making videos about video games. Like that's all I ever really want, you know? There are sheep everywhere. We have hit the sheep gold mine. We hit the obsidian gold mine before. Now we're hitting the sheep gold mine. Good, good, good. Jeez, there are really so many. All right, well, I only need that money, so that's all I'm gonna do. I might knock down some of this stuff, though. Just because it's so quick. You know, it's like diamond axes are crazy. Oh boy, oh, baby zombie. Baby zombie, get out of here. Ooh, gotcha. All right, then, let's go ahead and pick up that experience at the least. Of course, we could use it for future enchanting. Ooh, what is this, creeper? Ready? Ooh. Oh geez, I'm getting a little disoriented myself when swimming like that. There you go. I am gonna start running a little low on arrows if I keep doing that, so gotta be careful. Well, I got most of what I wanted there. You know, just some wood, and then some, what's it called? Some sheep. That was pretty good. I don't know what's off the, I think we've adventure over there. Yeah, we definitely have. Because those were torches we saw in the distance. All right, let's go ahead back this way. And now, as we're going back, we'll keep our eye out for more Endermen. I don't see any currently, gotta look out for those purple eyes. So spooky. But this definitely seems like a great area for looking for Endermen. We did it in the last episode and it worked out pretty darn well. We got a few that I brought back to the house already between episodes. All right then, so I'm not currently seeing any Endermen, but that's what I like about these sand biomes, is that there's plenty of room for some to spawn in. And let me eat up a little bit, just because it looks like we need it. Nice and tasty salmon. But yeah, so I feel like it's like I always, when I talk about the cats, I don't know why, it makes me so nervous, but I mean, I'm comfortable with it with you guys, but I feel like in like, you know, normal everyday conversation, talking about the cats always makes me so nervous just because I'm like, I'm not afraid people will judge me because I feel like I'm over that part of my life. You know, it's like if people judge me for doing what I like to do, then they're probably not worth having in my life, you know? But it's just a matter of, I don't like it when people get the wrong impression of things. And that skews their judgment for better or for worse, you know, because I feel like, you know, Perspective is a really important thing. It's a staggeringly important thing for most people. And it's, you know, important to have that in your life. But, and it's like, cause you know, like if somebody goes, okay, how many cats do you have? And I go, we currently have 9 cats and one of them might have kittens soon. They're just gonna be able to think, okay, you have a problem. And it's like, we don't have a problem. In fact, it's sort of the issue, the opposite. We're trying to help people solve their problems by giving them homes because they didn't have any, you know? So it's just like, it's sort of weird. I haven't run into an issue where somebody has actually misrepresented our actions or judgment or anything like that. But it's sort of something I'm always scared is going to happen at the back of my head, you know? All right, let's back up a little bit. Where are all these monsters coming from? Is that the only monster nearby? Because honestly, we're not. I want to take one last peek for some Endermen. Not see any. Probably gonna miss one. We're gonna get a bunch of comments saying, Zebra, no, you missed an Enderman at this time. I'd be like, no, if only I could go back in time. Make a time machine, that would be fun. I feel like a time machine would be cool. I don't know. I don't know what I'm going on about. I'm just a little loopy, I guess, because we need our sleep. So let's go ahead and get some. Okay, so I got plenty of salmonella last me. That's the thing, the salmonella is like really, really good. Like when it comes to feeding. But I know, I always get comments on people telling me that I pronounce salmon wrong, but it's just the way that it works with my tongue, man. Zebra tongues are weird. Let's get this little bit of experience we missed out on over here. So with that being said, we got some things figured out here. And I want to patch this up a little bit, make it look a little bit nicer. It won't, okay, it might not look fantastic, but it'll at least work. If we can go ahead, let's get our spoon out. Oh geez, buddy, what are you doing here? Here, ready? Gotcha. So I'm just gonna go ahead and maybe just shovel out a bunch of sand. I feel like that could be really good. All right then. Cause it also has Unbreaking 3, which is just really, really good, darn good. You know, it's like, we'll be able to get so much sand with this thing before it even starts to break, you know? So I just wanna sort of fill in that gap that's going on there with everything, you know? Maybe that can help out a little bit. Cause I'm not really too clear on how to make sandstone, but at the same time, I'm not really trying to figure out just because I feel like it's a little bit of a waste of time. But I just wanna fill it out just because if we're gonna make a second base here, we might as well make it look at least operable, you know? Instead of it just being like full of this kind of issues. So let's see, let's first off, and with sand, it's sort of a little bit easier to maintain. Luckily there's nobody who's fallen down there because it's like I can start replacing everything from way up here. And it's like if it's, you know, there's stuff under it, it just fills it up itself. That's nice and good. All right. So we're gonna go ahead and try to fill this gap first and foremost. That way they're not falling down when they're trying to go into the house, because that seems to be a recurring thing that's happening. Just go ahead and do that. Maybe we could make like a fortress. Like maybe we could build walls around this place so that the villagers aren't getting out and getting killed, because I feel like that's something that's happening, you know? And you can make villagers breed, right? Or is that only a Minecraft PC thing? Is that not in Minecraft console yet? Because I would definitely like to check that out, you know? Like if we could get some villagers to breed and then, you know, sort of make our own little society here, that'd be really good. All right, so this is gonna be sort of the weird part. Cause one, I'm running out of sand, and two, you know, like obviously, like I said, I don't have any sandstone right now. Because we could leave like a giant gap here, you know, so that the monsters can't climb up here. But you know, it still might happen. Those things tend to happen in Minecraft. Let's go ahead, destroy this as much as we can. Good, good, good. Come on. Give me the sand. But it would be really interesting if we could build a big wall across here. I mean, I know that's sort of a tangent thought because it's like we don't really need to do that to get the platinum trophy, and that's the big focus of this series. But at the same time, it's fun to put in little projects like that. I feel like it makes it all a little more enjoyable. All right, let's go ahead, try to get this stuff figured out a little bit. Just like that. And then get over here. Just like that. Oh, is there something above my head? It is. Okay. So maybe we'll do some re-envisioning here. Because when it comes to this, it's like, for right now, it might even be better just to block it off. You know, it's like there's no villagers in here right now, correct? Good. And then maybe we'll just block this stuff off and not let them in. Just because it doesn't seem like it would benefit them too much to even be in there. And it just seems like a little trap they're gonna end up falling down. I feel like they're even like, we have to treat them like little kittens because it's like, if not, they'll get in trouble. And darn kittens, they do. They indeed do. I feel like eventually on the Zebra Bunch channel, I do want to do little vlogs maybe where we show off the cats. Look at that guy, he's like running on rooftops. Like he knows he ain't supposed to, but he's doing it. But yeah, I definitely think it would be cool one day to maybe do a vlog style thing where we show off the cats on my bonus channel, just because I thought that'd be fun. We have a lot of them at this point. So maybe being able to make little fun videos on it would be fun. All right, I'm thinking about what next steps we should do. I think we should go ahead, get this. I feel like we might have to make a jog home at this point. We might have to make a jog home at this point if we want iron, because I don't know how much we're gonna find out here in the wild. Sometimes it can be fun just redoing that kind of stuff, like going out, finding some iron. Maybe we'll make a quick jog, because honestly, if we could find iron here, it would probably be quicker than having to run all the way back, even if we did take the minecart, since it isn't a direct, it's only halfway. So let's try that out, just for some fun. Just for fun's sake, let's get over here and try to get some iron. And I hope you guys don't mind that I'm sort of taking things slow this episode. I'm just doing some things that I sort of just want to do. Like, I'm not doing anything super like, oh, this is our big goal for today. We must get it completed before we go. It's just more like, hey guys, I'm playing Minecraft. You know that, I know that, let's do it. All right then, so we're first gonna peek our little heads into like little caves like this, finding a whole bunch of nothing besides coal. Coal's cool, but I'm gonna leave it for now. Oh, just because I don't need it. Maybe somebody else will one day. Oh, ow, my zebra legs in pain now. I actually need to eat up. I'm just trying to look for different routes we might be able to travel. I mean, we'll probably find a higher chance in caves that are going down more opposed than caves that are inside the mountains going up, you know? This has a lot of enchantments. Now let's get up here, or over here, see what else we can find. This isn't my fortune. I used to have a fortune diamond pickaxe. That was really, really nice. But then eventually I died in lava. That's what happened. That stunk. I remember that like had me not playing the game for a few weeks because I was really bummed about it. I was like, oh, that was a good pickaxe. Rest in peace. All right, I'm not finding too many, you know, caves where I could possibly find iron here. I mean, I'm gonna keep looking. I'm not gonna give up or nothing, but right now, things aren't looking too positive. You know, like running around like this in a green biome like this reminds me of when I first started playing Minecraft way back in like 2011. Like, you know, like the first time I ever tried it, because, you know, everybody was like, oh, you gotta try this game. And it was really cool. It was like, you know, a lot more simpler. I think the game was a little bit more greener. It was a little more cartoony in that style. But I remember just running around having no idea what to do. And like, I remember I spent like an hour and I got like nothing accomplished, and I was trying to break some stone, just like this kind of stone, with like a flint that I found. And I was like, why isn't it working? Why does it take so long? What's with this game? And I had no idea that you could actually craft. Cause like I said, I didn't look at any tutorials. I just bought the game, booted it up, and was utterly confused. Uh-oh. Spy door, get out of here, spy door. Ugh. All right, and we don't even have any torches on us. I thought I brought torches, but I mean, what's it matter, man? What's it matter if I can't find any stinking iron? At this point, I might just have to start digging down. What's over here? Wait, is this where we came in from? I think it might be. There's some coal. Okay, I'm gonna get this coal. Won't need all of it, but I'll take most of it. All right, since I could take it so quick, I might as well take all the coal. There you go. And maybe it's like, if I can't find anything, I'll make some torches. We'll dig down in the next episode. I just don't feel like running all the way back to the house and then all the way back here. You know, it just seems like a hassle, even though this is also a hassle. So maybe I'm just making no sense. All right. Yeah, I think that's what we'll do though. Because we'll just make a little cave near the village. Because I think it's cool when you make, you know, it's like, I have all the cool stuff. I have diamond, I have iron armor. All I need now is just something. Yeah, some balls rolling here, man. I just need, okay, there might be stuff down here. Like, ow. I think it just would be helpful if we had, you know, an extra base so that, you know, I don't have to make that travel every time, especially since I want to be able to go down to the Nether and in the village area to see if maybe we can help, hopefully find a better location for another star. Still no iron though. Is there any over here? Doesn't appear to be. I mean, there is nooks and crannies all over the place here. Is there gonna be lava down here? Oh, it's just the sunlight shining through. A little bit of sunshine. Aha! All right then, how much do we need? I think we just need one, honestly. When it comes to flint steel, I think you only need one, yeah. All right then, so nothing over here, right? All right, we're gonna go ahead and get like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, just in case we need it. And we're gonna get on out of here. This is a spooky little cave and I am done with it. Now we just need flint, but flint we can get a lot more easier and we can probably get on the ground. So if I run into gravel just like this, we go ahead and scoop that up with my spoon. Thank you, thank you. Oh. Okay, what is going on around here? I don't see too much, but I don't even know which way we're going anymore. This is such a nice area. Oh, is that? Oh, that's like one of the big tree biomes. I like that. And there's a little mushroom. Basically, got these big trees. It's a big tree biome. Biome for trees that are big. All right, let's try to find our way back because I don't want to get lost because that would be an awkward situation. I think we'd all be off this way, right? Or maybe not. Oh, geez, I'm getting scared now. Where do we go? These look like little pyramids over here. Well, there's the winter biome, so I think we're close. We're close. We're just gonna go on the other side of this mountain, which is fine. Totally fine. All right then, so we're on our way back. The sun is setting. I have found my way towards everything. The bunnies are hopping, the birds are chirping, the squids are squidding. It's time to go home. Or not home, but at least to the village. The home away from home. But that's about it. I mean, I think that in the next episode, we'll go ahead and start getting things a little more figured out because we do have now the obsidian. We do now have hopefully a flint and steel because we did break a few flints and we can turn that into more very soon. But yeah, feel free to let me know about anything I talked about today. Let me know about all that kind of stuff. But I think that's going to be it for now. Thank you guys so much for watching today's episode of Minecraft PlayStation 4 Edition. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give it a like, share it with your friends and family, and of course, comment in the comment section below. What do you think about some of the crazy things we've done in today's episode? But either way, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time.